Now I request Ramesh sir to change the PPT to eNest 179, and meanwhile eNest 179 presenter should be ready for the presentation. Presenter eNest 179.
Sir, am I audible?
Yeah, you are audible.
Yes, ma'am.
Please turn on your webcam.
Sir, I turned it on.
Yes, sir, we can visible you. You can proceed.
Yes, sir. A warm and pleasant welcome to all of you present here virtually. Glad to meet you all. I'm Anita, doing my third B pharmacy. And my topic for the review thing is spike protein as a target for COVID treatment. Living with this uninvited guest nearly for a year and a half is really tough, and the second wave is hitting us harder. So 1 minute, sir, I'll adjust my camera. And now the cause for this is the SARS-CoV-2 virus, and which attacks the respiratory system and causing pneumonia and the acute respiratory distress syndrome. The COVID virus releases the single-stranded RNA into the body by the use of type 2 transmembrane serine protease and the ACE2 receptors, which leads to the fusion and endocytosis. And this viral RNA is translocated and the viral proteins are synthesized. With the help of the RNA polymerase RNA-dependent enzyme, the new RNA strands are produced for the new virons. So this leads to the release of virus load into the patient's body. And this is resultant infection causes the massive release of cytokine in the body, causing the cytokine storm. So to treat this, initially, anti-malarial drugs were used, that is chloroquine. And it increases the pH of the lysozyme, which causes the phagocytosis reaction. So now it is stopped using, we stopped using because of the other side effects. And now the other treatment strategies are plasma therapy. And the recently approved drug for COVID-19 is the 2-deoxy-D-glucose. And the drug used in India is the antiviral drug, that is RNA polymerase inhibitors, this remdesivir and lopinavir. It gets incorporated into the viral RNA and causing the hindrance for the replication and the chain termination. So my review is about targeting the receptor binding domains on the spike protein of the novel coronavirus, which stabilizes and where the linoleic acid stabilizes the log-desc conformation, giving rise to the reduction of the ACE2 receptor interaction. The structure of spike protein is revealed by the cryo-electron microscopic technique, which revealed that it has two subunits, the S1 and S2. The S1 subunit has the receptor binding domain, and the S2 subunit aids in the viral fusion, viral membrane fusion by forming the 6 helical bundle via the 2 heptid domain. And to determine this, the antibodies, SARS-CoV-2 surrogate virus neutralization kit is used for to the binding neutralization reaction. To detect, for the screening assay, the antibodies are incubated with the surface spike proteins of the COVID and the ACE2 receptors, and the optical density is determined by the mass spectroscopy. To determine the inhibitory effects of the linoleic acid or the free fatty acid, the desired amount of it is incubated with the surface spike protein or the ACE inhibitors, which is immobilized on the plate. The positive control is 50% DMSO. The experiment is done in triplicate, and the results are calculated and analyzed, and for the various polyunsaturated fatty acids. With the results, we clearly get to know that polyunsaturated fatty acids inhibit the viral entry. Firstly, they do not inhibit, they do not interfere with the receptor function, but they alter the properties of the cell membrane, interfere with the viral envelope, and changing the dynamics and altering the receptor function. And this leads to the distress of the cell membrane. Secondly, it also inhibits the type 2 transmembrane protein, transmembrane serine protease, and that is where the interaction takes place. So it inhibits that. Thirdly, also it irreversibly locks the surface spike protein, that is linoleic acid, binds to the SARS-CoV-2, triggers a locking down of hydrophilic anchor and a compaction of receptor binding domain trimer. So there's no way for it to get attached to the human ACE receptor. Therefore, no new virons are produced. Previously, this technique was used to develop a small molecule against the rhinovirus. And greatly, these antivirals were successful in the human trials. To conclude, free fatty acids have anti-COVID effects, and it inhibits the viral viral entry noticeably. And adding on to that, it also decreases the dose load of remdesivir dose as it synergizes with it. Thank you for this opportunity.
Yeah. Now evaluators can start the evaluation.
Anita, good evening.
Good evening, ma'am.
Okay, so as you say, these polyunsaturated fatty acids are very important in reducing the virus load, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So what is this polyunsaturated fatty acids?
Ma'am, they are the sterols or the cholesterol which are which have the hydroxy moiety.
Okay. Can you give some example of the steroids which are used in this therapy?
Ma'am, as of now, the research is going on. We've not developed to that level where any drug is used in formulator. But linoleic acid supplements can be used to treat, so that there's no we can control the viral multiplication, ma'am.
Yeah, that is true. But if we see the current therapy which is ongoing for the treatment, okay, so as per the treatment protocol, which steroids are normally prescribed by the doctors?
Ma'am, as of now, when I had the opportunity to visit the doctors, very few, they gave the omega-3 fatty acids sometimes, ma'am. But mostly now, as the research is going on, the ICMR Council is not approving prescribing the fatty acids, ma'am.
Okay. So, what are the probable reasons for the cytokine storms in the COVID patient?
And cytokine storm, because when the virus enters the body and it goes to the lungs, it replicates very fast. And when our body sees that there is so much of virus is released, and suddenly when all the inflammatory cells releases the cytokine, ma'am.
Okay. So what is the normal level of cytokine?
The normal level of the cytokine is, I'm not very sure of it, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Anita.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah.
Yes, good evening, Anita.
Good evening, ma'am.
Yeah, very nice presentation.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Yeah. So here you have mentioned two fatty acids. One is linoleic acid and second one is EPA, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So, can I know the reference for that?
Ma'am, I've referred many articles for this, ma'am, like from 6 to 7 articles. Like one main article which I referred is the article provided by the University of Bristol, ma'am. Researchers who submitted the articles from the University of Bristol.
Okay, fine. So, is in that article there is a side effect mentioned or not?
Ma'am, compared to the like anti-malarial drugs, there are a few for this omega-3 fatty acids, there are less side effects, but still more research is going on, ma'am. And now the best drug for COVID is the 2-deoxy-D-glucose, ma'am.
Okay, fine. And for the method here in cell line study in 96 well plate, you have mentioned the condition that is 15 minutes at 37 degrees Celsius.
Yes, ma'am.
So what is the rationale for that?
Ma'am, because the interaction takes place fast, ma'am. Because the interaction between the virus and the ACE2 receptor is fast, so that the 15 minutes is fine, ma'am.
What about temperature? Is there any impact?
Ma'am, temperature, we need body temperature, ma'am. It should be maintained at body temperature.
Right. Right. Perfect. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Ganida, nice presentation. But when you are presenting paper, the font size, that is very small. It is not easy to visible. So don't copy and paste as such what is available. You will make it as a small bullet points and you have to explain more. Okay, so more you are included here. I think this is based on any one research article, I think. You are not... compare all the articles.
Sir, I worked on 4-5 articles, but I mentioned only 2 here, sir.
Okay. So any review article means you have to compare those who are reported about this is only the research article. They are reported for fatty acids, which is responsible for spike protein. Okay. Any other targets for COVID-19 other than spike? Do you know any other targets?
So now recently, like we can inhibit the glycolysis, sir.
Glycolysis.
Yes, sir. The inhibition of glycolysis in the viral cell particles.
I asked any other targets for COVID-19, SARS-CoV-2, other than spike. Spike is one of the targets for COVID-19. Do you know any other targets available for SARS-CoV-2?
The disruption of the cell wall.
Okay, that is general. For SARS-CoV-2, what are the parts available in SARS-CoV-2?
So the viral envelope, the capsid, and the RNA, sir.
Only RNA. There is no any other targets?
No, so the spike protein, the viral envelope, and the capsid, and the RNAs are present, sir.
Okay. So what are the many graphs are given here? What it represents?
So the first graph represents the various polyunsaturated fatty acids are taken, and the binding of the poly the free fatty acids binding to the receptors binding domain, sir. So the second one is that this one. Sorry, sir.
Okay.
So the second graph represents. Yes, proceed. Hello, sir.
Yes, we'll continue.
Yes, sir. The second graph is a comparison graph where it is compared the linoleic acid and the EPA's action is compared with the positive control, sir.
Do you know what which is positive control, which is negative?
The positive control is the dimethyl sulfoxide is used because cell lines should be preserved from freezing, sir. So positive control is a DMSO. The negative control is the normal incubation, sir.
So what is the connection between AC2 and spike?
Spike protein, when the virus enters the body, the spike proteins get attached to the ACE receptors.
Okay. So you are inhibiting ACE2 receptor. This compound, sir, inhibits the ACE2 receptor, these two compounds, fatty acids.
They generally, what they do is, when it is given, they bind the subunits of the spike protein. They do not alter, they do not have any function with the ACE2 receptors. They bind the surface, I mean the spike proteins on the surface, so that they do not reveal the, I mean allow the RNA to enter into the body, sir.
Okay, good, sir. Okay, and finish. We'll start with the next one.
Thank you, sir.